Rising, you are rise, arise. So, y'all already know what we about to get into. We finna get into these messages. This message is going to be a psychic dream message. Somebody, this could be concerning me. And or it could even be concerning, you know, somebody else. Somebody else may be able to resonate with this too as well. But I had a dream that somebody was discussing my body count. Talking about my body count. So we have the Ace of Swords with the Sun, some type of truth or illumination or something like that. So let's see. Some truth or illuminate some stuff if somebody was lying on me. Somebody was discussing my life here with this Wheel of Fortune. Yep, Eight of Wands, communication. So why was somebody communicating talking about my body count? Seven of Wands. Somebody could have been either attacking me or defending me, y'all. We gonna find out. We gonna show find out what's going on. Why is who I have been with a topic of discussion? Or how many people I've been with? Why is that a topic of discussion? With this Six of Pentacles to the Queen of Swords, somebody could think I'm mean or something, or say I'm mean and I don't be giving myself to everybody. Somebody could be talking like it's a gift, like I don't give myself to everybody, like I hold back. I may have gave it to some, but I don't give it to everybody. You could say I'm strict or mean or whatever the case may be with the Queen of Swords. Yeah, stingy. We got the Four of Pentacles with the Two of Swords. The answer be no. Four of Pentacles, stingy, holding back energy. Somebody could be discussing this, saying I've been like this since the past with the Six of Cups. With my decisions. Somebody could be hating on me or something for somebody to have to defend me or something. with this Five of Swords and somebody discussing what I do or who I done been with. Somebody could be defending me or something. Is somebody defending me against somebody else? Yes. Okay, well, shout out to you who defended me. Okay, and fuck you to whoever somebody got to defend me in the first place. Honey, fuck you. Okay. Shit, you ain't got to explain nothing to nobody. I'm more so an open book. I done told the world what I done had going on. These people. People, people, people. With this Page of Cups to the Three of Swords, maybe somebody was discussing my childhood trauma or something. Or maybe explaining to somebody why I am the way I am. Don't explain nothing to no motherfucking body. You ain't got to tell them shit about my trauma. You ain't got to tell them shit that I've been through in my motherfucking life. You ain't got to tell them shit. Let them think what the fuck they want to think. Because whatever they think don't make it true. The fuck? This could either be my friend or somebody, this could either be my friend defending me, or this is somebody's friend that's trying to fucking discuss me. Somebody that somebody been celebrating with trying to discuss me, but listen. Shut the fuck up. And somebody like, she only done celebrated with three people. Don't tell them my business, even though everybody in the world fucking know. I think I done told them in the recording, just explaining, just giving them a little background about what I've been through and, you know, telling them my story. But, oh, hell nah. You ain't gotta speak out and offer them a motherfucking thing about me. The fuck? But thank you, though. Thank you for taking up for me. Oh, somebody must have been lying on me, trying to stab me in the back. Oh my. Oh my. So somebody been speaking lies about me, about how many people I've been with. Okay. So somebody been lying and stabbing me in the back. Temperance to the Queen of Cups. Could be saying I ain't divine, I'm a hoe or something. Wrong. Even the Three of Pentacles is showing I ain't gotta lie about nothing. I could tell my own damn story. I don't have to lie about shit. I tell you if I've been with more people. But no. I have only celebrated with three people. And I was 27, about to turn 28, when I started to celebrate with people in that manner, even. So, whoever disgusting me, trying to lie on me, whatever, I don't know what your motive is or why, kiss my ass. You can kiss my black ass. You hating ass bitch. Whether you a man or a woman, you can kiss my black ass. What is you so interested in me for? You want to know about my life? Why are you so interested in my vagina? And who done been in it? And what done occurred with it? Because I can guarantee you, I ain't going around asking about nobody's vagina miles or how many people they done been with or who you done fucked and who you didn't fuck. I don't give a fuck. And if something come across this table about somebody's sexual life or whatever the case, that's just, it came across the table. But honey, trust me, I don't give a fuck. I'm not about to go around asking about, oh, how many people she done been with, or, oh, she done been with 1,000 people. Fuck, I don't care. So why am I being discussed? Why does somebody have to defend me and how many people I've been with? If you want to know about me and you must know, well, honey, I had a traumatizing childhood. So with me having a traumatizing childhood and being taken advantage of and a lack of love and protection, I kind of was always kind of to myself. So when it came to matters of the heart or really dealing with people like that, I talk to people, like have conversation, or I had like a boyfriend before, but we didn't have sex or anything like that. I would be like more so to myself because of the things that I endured. And when I was younger, there was times where I tried to, you know, get into some form of relationship, and even a guy I dated tried to take advantage of me, and it was just like, oh, well, that's it for that. So I really didn't take to being in relationships or having a sexual life because of those things. More so kept it to myself. Then I got older. I ended up falling in love with somebody, and they awakened things within me. Maybe because they were sexual, they damn self, and they awakened things within me where I wanted to explore who I was sexually too. So that's why I would start to like dress more girly, got into the lingerie thing, and I love lingerie and like pajamas and stuff like that. That's why I started to create my own. So just in case anybody was like, "Oh, she be on the internet and she be dressing up," and I wanted to create my own lingerie line, and I was testing it out. And I'ma still do that shit. But anyway, I was trying to find my sexy. And find who I was sexually and as far as relationship wise, and I wouldn't even fall in love with nobody or nothing like that. I blocked it all off. Until I did, and I was about 24, 25 when that happened. But me and that person, we was just cool. And I just got to express myself with them. But we ain't never do nothing. But I got to be open. Like what was sexually on my mind, or as far as my lingerie and me dressing up, or doing videos or whatever the case may be, I got to open up in that manner with that person because I trusted that person. And then fast forward, to 2020, which should have known something was gonna be crazy about that year, because I ended up talking to somebody who been trying to talk, and then listen, y'all, when people be trying to talk to y'all for a long time and y'all don't talk to them, do not talk to them. Do not get it no chance. They might be feeling some type of way or something, because woo. So this guy been trying to talk to me since we was kids or whatever. So I ended up talking to him, and he definitely manipulated me. So I ended up dealing with him in a sexual manner. And, you know, he was like saying to me, like, well, that's probably why, you know, you don't ever want to open up or never want to be with nobody. And you don't ever want to do anything and this and this and that. So I'm just taking in what the manipulator motherfucker saying to me, like, oh, well, that probably is right. I don't give myself to nobody, and I'm not open. So when he had said that to me, it was like a trigger. You know, I'm crying because I'm in my head like, well, maybe that is, you know, maybe that is why, because I'm so closed off, blah, blah, blah. So I opened myself up to him. He was an asshole. And then I end up meeting somebody else, and that person been hurt before, and I've been hurt before, and they, you know, acted as if they was ready for something that they wasn't. Asshole. And yes, I did cuss these motherfuckers out because y'all was playing in my face. I'm not playing in your face. I be genuine, so you couldn't even say that I was green, so to speak, thinking that if I'm being honest about what I would want, and thinking you being honest about what you want, and then you play me, hell yeah, I'm gonna say something about it. So then I stopped dealing with them. They was both assholes, narcissists, ignorant as fuck, unhealed. And I was too, but I wouldn't try to put my pain or just try to deliberately hurt anybody, or if I see that I'm hurting you, I would, you know, back off. I wouldn't continue to try to manipulate you or come back and try to deal with you when I want to, or, you know, not treat you like shit. Like, so then though they didn't work out and they was dickheads and I enjoyed sex, so I'm like, I didn't want to stop. I'm like, well, but it was over. It was over. And then it was a friend that I knew for a while since I was younger. And one night, he just reminded me of myself. Like, I think he was manifesting or something, or like writing down the stuff that he wanted. And I used to do that. I used to be so passionate about a lot of things, and I lost it, you know, just going through life. You know, used to be artistic, all of that, into music, into just so many things, and I lost it, you know, going through a lot of different things in life. And when I seen him doing it, it just reminded me of me, and I was like, dang. And that's what I was like admiring and looking at. And he thought I was looking at him in a certain type of way. He like, don't look at me like that. But I was just admiring the passion that he had with whatever he was doing. And he was doing it while we was in the middle of, like, we was all, it was me, him, and his brother. We was all chilling and kicking it. So I'm like, I really admire that. Because we, you know, chilling, smoking, drinking, whatever the case may be. And you focused on your passions. Like, that's what I was looking at, because that used to be me. So he ended up making a suggestion, and I'm like, well, okay, because I trusted him. I ain't think that he'd play me or hurt me. So he ended up making a suggestion. We didn't have sex right away. It was probably like a month or over a month after even the suggestion was made. And then we end up dealing with each other. We made a whole little agreement and all of that. And of course, he broke it. Of course, he turned into somebody that, shit, I'm like, who do I even ask? I'm like, well, who is you? I mean, I can laugh about it now, but that shit hurt the fuck out of me, because he was one of my favorite people. You know, one of the people that in my life, like, really ain't try to hurt me or dog me. So he was like one of my favorite people. So him doing that, it like, I ain't gonna lie, it did me in, but I'm kind of happy though that he did it, because by him doing that, it just made me look at everything for what it was and not for what I wanted it to be or painted people to be. Just look at the truth of what it is. And I mean, after I got hurt by that person, I changed, and I changed for the better. You know, I stopped playing with people and just how they did me, how they treated me. I take that for what it is, and I leave, because I don't deserve to be treated like that. And that's me loving myself. So even though sometimes I wish that that person ain't do that to me, I'm glad that they did, because I wouldn't be who I am right now. It was something that hurt me really bad that pushed me forward. But I can laugh about it now. And y'all, I swear, man, what's funny is I swear that motherfucker was gearing up to fucking shit on me or something, because oh man. And these is people, like, ain't none of these people I just had like, ooh, a one night stand with or something like that. No. The one I've been knowing since high school, we had classes together, all of that, and we didn't talk like throughout the years. I just never gave him a chance because I was a commitment phobe too. Commitment phobia. I wouldn't commit to anybody. I think the first and only one that I really truly ever really committed to in my life is the Most High Yahweh, y'all. And that's just me being honest. And then the other one, I talked to him for almost a year before I even dealt with him either. And then, of course, the friend that I was telling y'all about, I knew him since I was a child and been around him a lot. So, yeah. Don't try to play me. Don't try to discuss me. You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Shut the fuck up. If anybody else say anything otherwise outside of that, they a motherfucking lie. I have experienced, you know, molestation, being touched, sexual assault. Yes, I have. But as far as me giving myself to somebody and I am in agreement, it only happened 3 times. So after that, I recycled my first. I was sexually assaulted. But the thing about this, when I was sexually assaulted this time, I said something, like I stood up for myself. And it was something that I never did as a child. I just let it slide on by and deal with it for real, in an unhealthy manner. You know, by closing myself off and this and this and that. But anyway, I recycled my first, and then I just couldn't do it anymore because I know how that person treated me. I knew that I shouldn't, so I just couldn't even do that no more, just to recycle that, just to hit it. Like, it didn't sit right with me in my soul, in my heart, or in my sphere, so I just cut it all off. And that's the last person I dealt with, and that was, now it's over 2 years ago. And I haven't dealt with nobody since then. Not saying that I won't, but I had a lot to heal from, a lot of sexual trauma, and before I get back out there and deal with other people, not saying that I won't get hurt again, hey, but I will be more healthier. So, don't disgust me, okay? Because you obviously do not fucking know me. Don't fucking disgust me. I'm not nice in that department, for real. even when I did it then, it took for me to be high, it took for me to be drunk, it took for me to get motherfucking manipulated, and I was at a low point in my life then. So don't fucking disgust me. And splitting the deck, Ace of Swords, that's the fucking truth about me. In my life, Wheel of Fortune, since you're so fucking concerned about my pocketbook. What the fuck? Since you're so concerned about my vagina. Honey, getting my vagina is a gift. And unfortunately, sometimes some people didn't treat it that way. But that ain't got nothing to do with my value and who I am. Okay, sweetheart? Don't disgust me. Or, I just told you what it was, so you don't have to ask anybody any questions. Confirmation. You ain't gotta ask nobody no questions. I just told you everything. All naked, all out for the world to hear, for the world to know. Now, let's see what's T on you, though, because let's see what's going on with you. What you discussing me for? Honey, why am I on your mind? And why is my vagina on your mind? You know, since you can discuss me, let's see what's really going on with you. What's tea with this person is discussing me? No facts. Never has the facts make shit up lies. So you a fucking liar. I must have upset you, hurt you, made you sad. I don't know how, but okay. Never no facts, so you always making up shit. You could be facing some sort of bankruptcy or something. Okay? You always talking shit. Or you could feel like I'm always talking shit. Cause if something come across my shit, my radar, I'ma discuss it. I'ma talk about it. Oh, you're triggered about me. I trigger you. Okay. So that trigger is something for you to learn within you. If I trigger you, that's something for you to work out in yourself. Not try to project onto me, baby. Okay? Okay. Okay, so you're toxic. Okay, you got a lot of bad habits. You be on the same shit different day. Okay. What else is tea about this person to be discussing me? You're obsessed. You're dangerous. You're toxic. You're unhealthy. And you're karmic. Okay. It's starting to make sense now. It's coming together. You're karmic, of course. Oh, you're a karmic friend. You're either this person's karmic friend that you're discussing me with in my body count, or you could be my karmic friend. Karmic friend, can't fully trust them, tension, secret competition. So you in secret competition, you know to keep it a secret, because I run laps around your motherfucking ass. You know to keep it a secret, okay? Just like you're secretly discussing me, okay? You could be somebody's fuck buddy, lover, you sex fix, or you want to fuck on somebody or something. It got you up in your head, overthinking, overanalyzing, and stressed because I'm considered to be an idol, loved, respected, and admired. Okay, so you're also a fan. Somebody could be giving you money, or you give money. You done caught an STD, a rash, or a sexual infection. from you having all of these romantic love affairs. So you're the one to be having a whole bunch of romantic love affairs, but you're talking about me. Okay. 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 You don't want to be chasing love, but you're talking about me. Okay. And this could be me dodging and blocking negativity, escaping crazy people and haters, because you a hater. So I'm going to have to hit the matrix on what you was talking about. You be talking about me, so I got to dodge that shit and hit the matrix and shit. Because you the hoe. Trying to put that on project on me. What you got going on, you confused asshole? You don't even know which way you go, whether you a masculine or a feminine. And you feed off me, too. You try to steal my creativity as well. What's up with that? You feed off me? You could be having car troubles or something like that. You just clout hungry. Don't discuss me to get no clout, you motherfucking groupie. Your ass tripping on me, though. You're tripping on me. What's with these mushrooms? You're tripping on me, though. I give you a trip. I give you a high to discuss me. It gives you a high to be my groupie. You're always fucking partying, too. You might want to calm that down as well. And just know I'm not mad about what you say, but I'm going to clear it up. We're going to give truth around this motherfucker. I'm going to just dust it off. I ain't worried about you. But you're not going to lie on my name, though. That's my name, honey, bunny. So it gives you some type of high or some type of rush to be a groupie and be clout hungry and make shit up on me. Okay. I guess I do it for you. I guess I do it for you. You want to get married or mess with somebody for money. That's all you care about. You want somebody to be into you, okay? You want somebody to feel like you're the vibe. Okay. I see you. I see you. You might end up facing some legal issues or something like that. We got love triangle, so you want to be the choice, okay? You be trying to look me up, study me, get info on me, and your info ain't even correct. You're drinking piss. But you want to be the choice. You want somebody to take your ass to the courthouse or get some type of legal documentation of y'all being together. That's what the fuck you want. Okay. Okay. I see you, honey. But just know I'm not in your way. So you don't need to fucking discuss me, bitch. Shit. I ain't in your motherfucking way, salty hoe. You got too many. Oh, no, you ain't trying to. Your manipulating ass better go ahead somewhere, little bitch. Whether you a man or a feminine, I don't give a fuck. Too many bodies, you done lost count. And you trying to talk about me and discuss how many bodies I got, and you don't even know how many you got? And you be on the same shit, different day? Many faces of fuckery? You got many faces. So you trying to project and try to put that shit onto me because you have so many bodies that your ass done motherfucking lost count. You little dirty hoe. You a woman scorned is what you is. But I ain't scoring your whole clown ass. So watch it. Watch it, baby, with your two-faced ass. You two-faced fuck, man abuser, liking to lick, like, and love on everything, and all you do is tell half-truths and use mind fuckery. You fucking weirdo. Don't disgust me, because I will hurt your motherfucking feelings, ho. Don't want to, but you're trying to play me. You want me to be hurt. With this Three of Swords, you want me to be hurt, because you're hurt. No, go fucking heal. you fucking rat. Go heal, you motherfucking rat, you fucking loser. This is you, a fucking clown. A fucking loser. This disgusting me. Don't even know how many people you done fucking been with. With your balled up motherfucking money. Thinking you, I guess you think you better than somebody, okay? But you're not. Strength, you're weak. You could be a man. You could be a man. Somebody got Leo in their chart. You a man or you a woman. You got Leo in your chart somewhere. You either a dick dealer or you get dick dealt to you. Your ass is under judgment. Watch who you discuss, motherfucker. Watch who the fuck you discuss. You could have been molested too as well. Younger. You could be living in the past with that. I hope you heal. Don't nobody deserve that. Oh, this is you. You live for the one night stands and shit with your fake flex and lying ass. You a snake. That's what you is. You're a motherfucking snake. You're a motherfucking snake is what you are. I do see hate messages. You must hate me or something. Please keep your distance. Fuck boy, fuck girl alert. Somebody a damn player. Like, go ahead somewhere. Because we get the truth about you. See, you just trying to discuss lies about me. But here go the truth about your raggedy ass. You the one doing all of the fucking and sucking. Or fucking and eating. Or hell, you could be fucking and sucking too, hell. Yeah, mattress back. Freaking the sheets and a whore on the motherfucking floor. But you talking about me. Okay. It done came out here like 3 times that your ass is a hoe, a whore, or a whoremonger. If you don't get shut the fuck up and close your motherfucking legs. Probably don't even smell right. Your ass gonna get karma. Your ass is going to get karma. Karma, karma, karma. For who you discussing. Because you discussing the wrong one, motherfucker. You're discussing the wrong one. Somebody that ain't discussing you or your motherfucking sex life. Yeah, you wearing a mask. Your ass be wearing a mask. But we gonna find out what could I have possibly done to trigger you. Maybe because it's who I am and who the fuck you ain't. Anything with these with the news here? Yeah, energy warning. Don't trust. Don't trust this person discussing me. Shit. Mood swings. Can't trust they energy. Yeah, just leave. Because it's not working out. Oh, man. What is going on? Oh, somebody's trying to steal somebody money. Money got jacked. Somebody got wild emotions, so somebody's stealing. But you're disgusting me. Nothing feels better than this. So somebody could like the same sex. Nothing feels better than the same sex. Okay, somebody triggered because I'm doing better without they ass. Okay. This is obsession. Of course I'll be doing better without somebody discussing me like that and lying on me. A duh. A fucking duh. Bye, Felicia. Bye, Felicia. Okay. A shout out to whoever was taking up for me and telling the damn truth. I do not fuck around like that. Ooh, look. Slut shaming the blessed. Look what came out. Oh, that's like, listen, y'all. Thank you, Yahweh, Elohim, Yahshua. Always having my back. Look what popped out of this deck. The first thing that popped out of this deck is blessed slut shaming. You're slut shaming the best, but you're the slut. Bye, Felicia. Yeah, can't even deal. Can't even deal. You must wanna Netflix and chill with me or something. Whether you a masculine or a feminine, go ahead somewhere. Or your ass always Netflix and chilling. Beat it, okay? Just beat it. Trying to slut shame the blessed. I ain't even gonna pull no more out of that deck. There we go. Blessed. And then you're trying to slut shame me. But you don't even know what you're talking about. You can't slut shame me. I ain't no slut. Bitch. So what's triggering this motherfucker? Why is this person so triggered about me trying to slut shame me and shit? Trying to slut shame a divine messenger and they calling? That's stupid. And even before I got into my calling, motherfucker, I wasn't no slut. The fuck? You trying to slut shame the judgment hierophant? Okay. Nine of cups, single. Pisces energy. Oh, you could be upset or triggered because I'm in my calling, because I realize my dreams, because I'm happy, I have joy, I get pleasure, because I have high self-esteem. Let me guess, you have low self-esteem, and you're wondering why I have high self-esteem, huh? It's really giving you think you're better than somebody, but it's really looking like you're a fucking dud. But that bitch a lemon. That's what it's fucking giving. You giving lemon? You old sour puss. Sour balls. I don't give a fuck who you is. You fucking sour ass motherfucker. You're triggered because I chose a different path and I'm happy. I'm in the Ten of Cups. And I'm gifted with this Ace of Pentacles. Because I'm committed to what I got going on. And you this devil ass energy. You could be... Who the fuck is this? I would really like to know who you is discussing me for real. Cause I made a decision to be happy and I'm committed to what I have going on, committed to my own business, and you're obsessed. You want to bind me down. You got a crush on me. Whether you a masculine or a feminine with this Page of Cups, you're crushing on me. That's what it is. That's why you talking about me. You're crushing. You have a crush. You have a crush. So you're a fan, a stalker, obsessed, and you're mad. Okay. You're mad at the foundation that I'm laying. That's what triggers you. Me having good news, me having opportunities, me being happy, me being on a different path, that triggers you. It hurts you. Three of Swords. You're hurt. Okay. So I ain't gonna cut into you too deep. You're hurt. But that's for you to gain an understanding on. You're hurt by my power. You're hurt that I'm awakened. You're hurt that I'm in my legacy. It hurts you that I have psychic powers, that I'm in my full power, that I do things with integrity, that I have the willpower, that I can create, that I have influence, that I am intelligent, that I'm awakened, that I'm blessed. Damn. That's fucked up. If it was you, I'd be happy for you. Why you're not happy for me? Because I'm in my legacy. Because of my foundation. Because of the action that I take, because I can get through, you know, battles spiritually, physically, because I still got the victory and I'm skilled, because I'm strong, because I'm getting recognition, because I'm gifted, because I get spiritual guidance or give it, because I'm in my Ace of Pentacles, something that the divine gave me. You don't want me to be gifted? You're obsessed. You're obsessed. This is the truth. And if something gonna blow up in your, oh, okay. The tower was that I'm a high priestess to you. The tower is that I'm connected to a higher power. The tower is that I'm actually the divine feminine and you salty about it. Ooh, not my problem. Not my problem, baby. You mad because somebody the King of Swords on you and probably stepping in their power on your ass? Because they done defended me. That's what you're mad about. Okay. Again, not my problem. You're mad because you're a karmic. Not my problem. So that's why you disgust me. That's why you take the quick action with the Eight of Wands to try to disgust me. Seven of Cups, them is fucking illusions. Seven of Wands, them is attacks. So you can try to steer the direction here. But you might want to abandon that because even disgusting me in that manner will get your bitch ass karma. You the Eight of Swords. You the Five of Cups. You sadder than a motherfucker. You're in despair. You're depressed. You're hurt. You're the Eight of Swords. You have psychological issues. You're powerless. You're unawakened. But you're disgusting me. You tied up for real. And you're disgusting me. Or you want to tie me up and sacrifice me or something, but honey. Oh yeah, that's what you want to do. You so crazy. Boy, girl, you so crazy. You ain't finna tie me up. You could try, but I'ma bust up out that bitch. I'ma bust up out that shit. Cause that's what I do. You know? You ain't finna tie me up in no shit. Honey. Sorry. Damn. You wicked. You wicked as fuck. You definitely wicked. I don't think I like your energy at all. I don't like you. You want to tie me up and block me off and you want me to be unstable. You're weird. I don't like you. Well, I'm going to say I don't like your actions. I don't like your actions. I don't like the way you think. I don't like the way you do business. You are not my cup of tea. But I think you should keep your motherfucking mouth off me. keep your dick suckers, pussy munchers, vagina munchers off of me. Ooh, I guess I must, this must be meant for me to read these. If you don't love who he sent and don't want to hear who he sent and still think you going to get it, you may just end up blocked. You need to cleanse and get out of your own way. So you don't have love for who the divine sent. You don't like that I'm the messenger. You don't like that I'm the high priestess. You don't have love for who he sent. Well, that's going to be on you. We have atom, protons, neutrons, electrons. It's a whole pattern. His purpose, plan, and pattern. We are all one. We're all negative. We're all positive. Honey, we got the most holy place. Yahweh. You are loved. And you are loved by the Most High. You are loved. And I'm definitely loved by the Most High. Here goes an image of the most holy place where Yahweh dwells. Watch who you discussing, honey. But here we go. Right there at the top, the most holy place. The entrance. Oh, that's deep. I see. The entrance, second veil, the Ark of the Covenant, the two cherubims of glory with their wings overshadowing the mercy seat, contains the Ten Commandment law written on tables of stone. Those blues, purple, scarlet veil. This is the tabernacle, fashioned after the Most High Yahweh. We're all fashioned after the Most High Yahweh. That's why I be always telling y'all, go read Exodus chapter 25 through 40 because it's very detailed. And the divine don't just say, hey, hang them curtains up. Hang blue, purple, scarlet curtains up and do that throughout the whole thing. No, he gonna tell you in detail how to do it, how many to put in what, and he gonna do it one by one because of your makeup and how your body is even made. It tells a story. Everything is all about Yahweh. Everything. There's purpose, there's his plan, and then there's that pattern. A lot of things come in threefold, and it's fashioning after the divine. But what you're gonna do is block. You think you trying to block? I don't know what you think you doing. But all you're gonna do is block your access. That's why your ass in the Eight of Swords now. You ain't awakened. Your superficial ass. Okay, let's see. Anything else? Yeah, you deceptive. You sneaky. You deceptive. Your ass got hidden motives and shit. You need to heal. You need to renew yourself spiritually instead of trying to do magic and shit. You're weird. You want to try to cause an imbalance any type of way. And if you ain't doing magic, you're using your mouth. You're putting your mouth on me, motherfucker. You need to heal. You think you're being hidden, but you're not. Whatever solo magic you did on me or is doing on me, I always heal from it. I am in alignment, and all I will do is resurrect. That's it. So that little solo magic that you doing, you is doing magic, actually. That little solo magic you doing, it ain't gonna fucking work. You're weird. Like, go sit the fuck down somewhere, for real. You're talking about me, you're doing magic, you're trying to cause my death, but I'm protected from that too as well. Protection, honey. You doing death magic on me. You dumb bitch. Little dumbass wizard. Witch. You doing death magic on me, ho? And discussing me? You weird bitch. You fucking weirdo. That shit ain't gonna work. I done already transcended, honey. I'm one with the divine. Something that you should be looking into instead of trying to kill somebody. You dumb bitch. I'm still at peace. Still channeling energy. Just like how I'm channeling your dumb ass and what the fuck you doing in the background. You be trying to glamour my energy too. You want to walk in my likeness and image for real. You little dingbat. I don't even know what the fuck that is with you little fucker. You about to have an ego death. A tower about to blow up in your face when you doing this magician work and this glamour magic and shit. You doing glamour magic, death magic, you piece of shit. Nah, I ain't talking to you nice. I thought I was. I was going to try to, you know, calm down. Because, you little dumb bitch. Don't be trying to kill me. Even though it ain't going to work. But damn. You fucking weird. You a weird hoe. Yep, trying to offer me up. Look, trying to offer me up. You think I don't know you doing that? Oh, I pays attention. You been trying to offer me up because you want my essence. You want my essence. You want to be the temperance angel. You want to be the divine feminine. You want to be the judgment. You want to be the higher fire. You want to be the one connected to heaven and earth. Now, how the hell you want to be that and you trying to do all that to me? Who is connected? You dumbass little bitch. Excuse me, y'all. Excuse my French. But you's a dumb bitch. You trying to offer me up to death because you want my essence. You want to be the motherfucking temperance angel. You want to be the motherfucking divine feminine. You want to be the one in my motherfucking calling sharing knowledge. But you sitting up here doing motherfucking death magic and shit. You stupid ass bitch. I wouldn't give you shit to be in control of like that. You fucking weird ass motherfucker. You think you gonna get it that way? By trying to kill me? And by trying to block me? And by trying to talk about me? You think Yahweh, who I am loyal to and who is loyal to me, gonna be like, well, here. You trying to kill my baby, so I'm gonna give you everything of her. Here go her essence. Here you go. Here you go. Bitch. Okay. 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 Honey, I'm spiritually guided. You done lost your motherfucking mind. You're crazy. I don't even. And whoever, if you end up listening to this and you've been defending me or whatever, stop talking to that motherfucker about me for real. Shut that shit down. Don't even defend me. Don't discuss me. None of that shit. Because whoever the fuck this is fucking shot the fuck out. Don't discuss me about shit. Don't discuss me at all with this bitch. They want to offer me up. They want me to just die. Don't discuss shit about me with this bitch. Because I'm the Empress. Bitch mad. And I got a higher perception. Bitch mad. And that's why that witch shit ain't working. Witch in motherfucking reverse. Bitch. Because my aura is of the truth. Loyalty. Already been initiated. Intergalactic mastery. Already master self. You could even been trying to say I'm a motherfucking witch. I ain't no witch, bitch. Honey. I mean, well, you could say I am by doing the tarot and stuff like that. But, bitch, I'm so much more. You have no motherfucking idea. Stupid ass. That's why you want my aura and shit. No, I'm just connected here. Why you doing that abracadabra shit? Ugh. Because I get my messages from the cloud. This is what you salty about. Because I know who the fuck I am. And you want to connect in that way. And you can't. Because I'm a great diviner. Confirmation. You mad about my motherfucking guidance here, ho. This is ridiculous. Yep, because I'm one with the divine. This is what you mad about. So you doing sorcery, trying to create bullshit in somebody's life. Bitch, I'm free. You can't motherfucking create shit in my motherfucking life. Because I'm going to get free from that shit every time. I'm going to get the justice every time. Because, bitch, I'm beyond you. In the beyond love me. Regardless of what the fuck you think it's supposed to be. Or, oh, why. It is what it is. And while you doing that sorcery, I'm going to have peace. Bitch, you better learn how to take some motherfucking accountability for who the fuck you is. You dusty bitch. You're mad because I am of the light. I got the keys. And I bring truth and justice. That's what the fuck you mad about. You're mad about how I alchemize that shit that you be doing and sending. Dumbass bitch. You're mad because I have a high tolerance and still have balance in the chaos. Even with what you do. So whoever been discussing me with somebody and they been trying to discuss my body count and you been having to motherfucking defend me. Listen. Stop talking to that bitch about me because that bitch doing a lot of shit. That I don't approve of. Now, I'd have been cool because, you know, you just discussing me or whatever. So, I'm going to say what I say. And we see what's what with you. But the fact that you trying to kill me with some motherfucking magic with your dusty ass. We got a problem. I don't like you. Well, I don't like what you do. Let me stop saying. I don't like what you do. Because I don't even know who the fuck you is to say I don't like you. But I do not like what you do. You about raggedy as fuck. And your ass gonna get karma. So depending on what you was doing, you might want to slow up. Because your ass might be the one getting offered up and on the chopping block, bitch. I don't know what the fuck be wrong with these hoes. You hate me so much and disgust me so much, but you want to be me and have my motherfucking qualities and shit. You want my gifts and shit. You want my position and shit. But you hate so motherfucking much. Sit the fuck down. I ain't even pulling no signs. It don't even fucking matter. I was about to pull some signs. Honey, it don't matter. Honey, fuck you and a horse that you done rode in on trying to do dumb shit. Excuse my French for people who don't like that type of language. You gonna have to excuse me, but I'ma still talk motherfucking freely. Don't discuss me with no bird. Don't discuss me with no bird, bitch. Whether masculine or feminine, I don't give a damn. Don't discuss me with no motherfucking bird. Hang up on that bitch or leave the room. You ain't gotta defend me from no bitch like that. Shit. Yahweh gonna defend me. But I don't want, no, don't discuss nothing about me with no bitch like that. Anyway, Yahweh will be your light forever. Cast your burden onto Yahweh and he will sustain you. He will never permit the righteous to be moved. I meditate on your name all night, Yahweh, treasuring your revelation, O Yahweh. Yahweh will fulfill his purpose for me. Your steadfast love, O Yahweh, endures forever. Yahweh holds the hands of his people. And here go the protection prayer right here. He who dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Always be full of joy in Yahshua. I say it again, rejoice. Yahweh, I will give you thanks for you answered me. You have become my salvation. Thank you for saving me, especially from this tweaked out bozo. I don't even got the words, boy. But y'all, I'ma go on and exit up. Oh no, I'm gonna pull some music. Let's get some music and then I'ma go on and exit right on up out of here. All up in my business. Weird ass bitch. But you know what? I ain't even gotta do nothing to you. You gonna take yourself out. Cause you that motherfucking weird. The Dream, Spiritual. Omarion featuring Wale Mutual. Guapel, Closer. Mary J. Blige, My Life. That's perfect. I might even play that. If you look and see what I see. Kevin Gates, right game, wrong nigga. You got the right game, but you got the wrong motherfucker. We got Lloyd featuring Teddy Riley, Slow Wine Bass. We have Primo Rice, Malaysia featuring Larry June. We have Rod Wave, Fuck the World. SZA, Good Days. These songs could have extra messages. Party Next Door, Thirsty, because this bitch thirsty as fuck. LaRouche's Bulletproof. Drake, Now and Forever, that was at the top. Let's get one more song. These songs could have extra messages. I might end up, Her, I'm Not Okay. These songs can have extra messages in there. We got Rihanna, Higher. Janae Aiko, Microphone Check, Trying to Smoke, and Coi Leray, No Parties. Okay, because don't invite me to shit. But I'm a end this. I'm gonna play this Mary J. Blige song. But them is songs that you could have listened to, because whoever involved. The Masculine, me, and your shout out ass, whoever the fuck you is. Or was it a Masculine energy that was taking it? That's what I seen in my dream state though. La 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 la.
It's all on you, what you're gonna do.
If you looked at my life, see what